Hey guys, welcome to another video. I was going to do this video as part of the vlog, but decided not to. I decided to make it a separate video because I get asked this quite often. So basically the question is, why don't I vlog using, you know, the GH4 or a big camera like an SLR or something like that? And the main reason for me is simply it's all about the size. Like the GH4, it isn't huge for an SLR style of camera. It isn't an SLR camera, but it's a similar shape. It's quite small and very light for what it is, but it's just still too big to carry around. As most of you know, I use the Canon G7X Mark II, nice and small. Compared to this, it's a monster. So right now I'm shooting this on the GH4. The internal audio on the GH4 is obviously terrible. It's terrible on most cameras. So on top of that, right now I'm shooting with a Rode VideoMic Pro. So that just makes the package even bigger, and then I need something to carry the camera around with, such as a GorillaPod, and you're looking at pretty much a Casey Neistat setup. Like I said, it's all about the size for me. The quality on this camera is awesome, but it's when you're uploading to YouTube every single day, you don't want to deal with the file sizes, the editing, all that stuff's a strain on the computer. This camera shoots in 4K. Yes, I can shoot in 1080, but the file sizes are still much bigger because the bit rate that this camera records at is way higher than something like the G7X. So as I said, you end up with bigger file sizes, it takes longer to edit, more strain on the computer. The files are bigger when you render them out, they take longer to upload. It's just this massive vicious circle of things just getting bigger and bigger and harder to do. Now, I love this camera, obviously. I use it for professional stuff. I use it for the reviews and tutorials. It's easier just because it sits on the tripod. It's easy for me to do tutorials and reviews from it. The vlogs where I'm out and about, there's nowhere to put the camera. So as I said, getting back to the size, there's nowhere to put this camera unless I have a backpack or something. Yes, you can carry it around, but there's a lot of places that people might not let you in because you've got a massive camera, or people might look at you weirdly. Eventually you get over that, but yeah, there's places where they might say, you know, sorry, you can't bring a camera in here or whatever. G7X, I've done a review on this camera. In my opinion, it's one of the best vlogging cameras ever made. This just sits in pretty much any pocket that I have, or if you want one of those little satchels you can clip on your belt, anything like that, it fits in it. I just put it in my jacket pockets or even my pants pocket sometimes. It fits perfectly. The quality is more than good enough for YouTube. It shoots 1080p. It's more than good enough for YouTube. The file sizes are small. You can edit quickly, render quickly. File sizes are small enough to upload quickly. So everything just ends up being faster and easier. I do understand the quality on this camera that I'm shooting with now is awesome, and the depth of field you can get and things like that look really, really cool. The only time I use this camera for vlogging is if I go on a trip and we go somewhere where it's fine for me to carry a big camera, if that makes any sense. God, stop. Sorry. So if I go somewhere where it makes sense to carry a big camera, like I might go to the zoo or something, that's just a stupid example, but like when I went to Adelaide, this was like my first ever vlog. I did an Adelaide vlog and I used this camera, and it did get really annoying to carry around. I had nowhere to put it. I ended up putting it in a shopping bag when I wasn't using it because I couldn't be bothered bringing the backpack as well. So just, yeah, for me it's about size, portability, the fact that this thing I can just throw in my pocket and go. It's awesome. The other thing I was talking about before as well is how much data that this camera uses when it records video. It also means you fill up cards quicker, you have to have more cards. Everything, like I said, everything just becomes longer, more expensive, and just harder to do. So that's why, in a nutshell, I don't vlog on an SLR or the Lumix GH4 that I have here. As good as the quality is, and as much as I'd love to, it's just too hard to bring around and all that stuff. So that's why, again, I shoot on the Canon G7X right here. And I think that's about it. That pretty much covers the reason why. Another reason is the GH4 is quite an expensive camera, not the most expensive camera, but it's quite expensive, and I do use it for professional stuff, and that's about the only time that it will leave the house. Other times, for tutorials and reviews like this, I use it. I don't want to sacrifice the safety of this camera vlogging, because the amount of times that I haven't dropped the G7X yet, but the amount of times it gets bashed around, you're going to take it places where you don't really want to get it smashed or damaged. So that's another reason why I don't bring the GH4 out for vlogging, because anything can happen. It gets stolen, damaged, all that stuff, and I can't really afford for that to happen to the best camera that I have. So that's why, again, G7X, that's why I shoot on that. Any point and shoot's good for vlogging, as long as it's decent in terms of resolution and quality. And if you're looking for one, then I definitely would recommend the Canon G7X. I'm not sponsored in any way at all. I've just been using it for a long time now, and it is an awesome little camera. So that's it, pretty much the end of the video. Hope that helped. Hope I covered everything. If you have any questions at all, please let me know in the comments below. Please subscribe, please like, and that's all. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.